Okay. Okay, now we are going to talk about reactions on pivots. You can take a quick look at this diagram where we now have a beam or a rod and a force of 200 newton hanging at a given point, and the rod is on two pivots, which means this 200 newton is now resting on these two pivots. So I can call here pivot P and call here pivot Q. So we now want to determine the force or the reaction that is experienced at pivot P and experienced at pivot Q. Take note, the other problems we've been solving, we were using one pivot, and hence it means that the total upward force is equal to the total downward force. Therefore, if the mass of the rule is 100 gram, that means the 100 gram will be experienced on that one pivot. But at this point, we have two pivots. This 200 newton has to be shared among the two pivots. How are we going to get these reactions? Notice that when a force is going down, these two pivots are giving off an upward and opposite force to cancel out the reaction. Hence, let us call the reaction at P. It is going up, we call it P, and the reaction at Q, we call it Q. How do we do this? P becomes the clockwise moment, and Q becomes the anti-clockwise moment. The first thing we do is to equate total upward force to total downward force. And the total upward force here is P and what? Q. That means that P plus Q has to give us the total downward force is 200. We can call it equation 1. Now, we now determine, using principle of moment, the reaction at either P or the reaction at Q. If we want to determine the reaction at P, that means we are taking the moment from Q. P is going the clockwise direction, and then 200 is going the anti-clockwise direction. So if we are looking for the reaction at P, that means we have to imagine that Q is not here. And hence, we now have only two forces, P and 200. What is the distance of P from this turning point? It is 4 plus 6, which is 10. And what is the distance of 200 from the turning point? It is only 6. And if we say that clockwise moment is equal to anti-clockwise moment, what is the clockwise moment? The moment of P, which is P multiplied by this distance, 4 plus 6, is equal to the anti-clockwise moment, which is 200 multiplied by its distance. That will give us 6. 4 plus 6 is going to give us 10. And hence, here we have 10P equals to 200 times 6 is going to give us 1,200. To find P, we divide both sides again by 10. 10, we cancel 10. P is remaining equals to 1,200 divided by 10 is going to give us 120 newton. And once we've gotten the reaction at P, we can now simply say that, remember, P plus Q is equals to 200 from equation 1, and P is 120. Therefore, we have that 120 plus Q is equals to 200, and therefore, Q is going to give us 200. 120 crosses over to become minus 120. Hence, Q is equal to 80 newton. That means that for this setup, the reaction at P is 120 and the reaction at Q is 80 newton. And that can be determined by the distances. You can see that this force is closer to P, and hence P has to experience more of the reaction. For more and complex problems in this, check out our exercises, and don't forget to check out our Pursue ME questions, WAEC, and JAMB. Thank you.